In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, the Blue Hose at home take two victories and look to get a third as an old rivalry is renewed. We'll take a look at that game with the Wofford Terriers, have our discussion with head coach Gregg Nibert, and a lot more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball. We welcome you to Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with the coach, Gregg Nibert. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Glad to have you with us on this Saturday. Well, the Blue Hose at home were just incredible against Bob Jones University. And then they took their show on the road as an old rivalry is renewed, the Wofford Terriers and the Blue Hose. Coach, it's been 20 years. You've had two games against them. It's nice to see Wofford and PC getting it on again.
Well, it was, Eric, and really excited about, you know, renewing that rivalry. It has been about 20 years since we played last when we were Division II, and excited about them coming to our place. They have an excellent basketball team, a team that went to the NCAA tournament last year, and everybody back, and it was a big test for us. We played well at times, but had a couple bad stretches offensively where we turned the ball over, a three-point game with about 14 minutes to go, and had some bad blockouts and some bad turnovers. But we're going to get better at that, and that will help us here getting ready for our, you know, open up the Big South on December 31st.
Against Gardner-Webb. And we're going to talk more about that Wofford Terrier game with PC. But first, PC got their second victory in a row at home against Bob Jones University. This is coming after the win against Toccoa Falls. And, Coach, I don't think your team could have played any better than what they did.
Well, it was great. I mean, even though it was a non-division one game, but it was really proud of our defense in terms of holding them to 39 points. And they shot 27% from the field and in the teens with the three-point line and blocked them out and took care of business and won it. 88-39 and played a lot of guys and had a lot of guys come in there and do some really good things. But it was really a great defensive effort. We played both man-to-man and zone. Mm-hmm. And this team is a little farther along defensively other than the blocking out. We're better in man-to-man. We're better in the zone, even though we've got to work a couple different areas, especially with our four-man and inexperience there. But we just now got to get our offense going and take care of that basketball. And hopefully we can do that in this non-conference season.
Coach probably wanted to go pop me in the chest when I said a perfect game or you know, that they won on every single aspect. A coach always wants his team to improve. And, boy, you hit the nail on the head because defensively, I really like how your team is playing defensively. Really guarding the shooters, guarding on ball, whether they're playing man-to-man, whether they're playing zone. I know you want to work on blocking out. We'll talk more about that when we take a look at the Wofford highlights. But with this very young team, Gregg, that you have, I really think that you like the progression of how they're developing, especially defensively.
Well, we are. And like I said, we won those two games, 63-40 against Toccoa Falls. We played great defense. We stressed that. I'm really proud of Jordan Downing and Will Truss's defense.
Oh, absolutely.
Jordan's defense on Cochran at Wofford, Jordan's defense the other two games against very good players. He's doing it. Now what he's got to do is he needs help from the other players, and excited about that. Know that will come because I know that those younger players want these seniors to go out as winners, and everybody's got to give a little bit more defensively. And then we're going to, again, work on that block out, work on taking better care of the basketball.
Coach, let us begin by looking at the highlights here at the Templeton Center as your Blue Hose take on Bob Jones University.
Game Highlights is brought to you by Cooper Motor Company. If you can't trade with Cooper, you just can't trade.
Well, we really moved the basketball well. They played a lot of zone. It was great. We just didn't take the jump shot there. Great finish there by Jordan. We're moving the basketball. We had a lot of assists, getting the ball inside there. Our two seniors, Jordan, threw the ball inside there to Will. Playing a little man-to-man. Great help defense there by Devon, doing something extra. Again, good drive right there, and then good finish there by Will Truss. Again, it all started with defense. Again, they missed. We're pushing the basketball. Great pitch ahead. Great kick out. Shot fake. Jordan really taking some great uncontested shots. But again, it all started with defense. Again, a little set play we're running here. All right. Swinging the basketball. Good job swinging the ball. Great shot there by Marcus Terry. And great feed from Devon. And we're moving the ball against the zone. Trying to get the ball inside there to Ruben at the high post. He makes a pass out. Driving at baseline. Really great job there by Janiel, which we need more of that and giving those guys the freedom. You know, sometimes it's just going to take some time. They think we want to, you know, just get the ball down inside and not drive the basketball. We're going to work on driving it. There's a nice little alley-oop there. Great pass. You know, a great screen there by Ruben. And great dunk by Jaron Withers. Again, getting the ball down there inside to Will against the zone. Great help in there by Jordan. And again, great help. And then that's what he gets at the other end. He's rewarded for getting a basket. Again, Austin shooting the ball really well, but great offensive rebound there by Ruben. And again, great step back at a guy 6'8". Again, great ball movement. Like for that to be a chest pass. Again, Jordan, they don't guard him. He jumps straight up there. And great contest there by Ed. Great rebound by Ed. Great, very unselfish here by Marcus Terry in a two-on-one, passing the ball to Janiel, and Janiel finishing. Again, on-ball screen there right before half, and shoot that ball right there with about 2 or 3 seconds. Great finish to a great half offensively and defensively. Again, moving the ball, they go man-to-man. Again, great crossover there by Jordan. Got a big guy on him. He recognized that. Again, moving the basketball, trying to get the ball inside the wheel. Good screen there by Ruben. And then great pass and kick out there for Austin Anderson.
And boy, did he heat it up in the second half.
Again, another play right there. When Jordan goes straight up and straight down. Again, another offensive rebound by Ed. And Ed doing a tremendous job, you know, not just going right up there and shooting it, passing the ball back out, and Devon Bell with the floater. Again, there's Will Truss at the high post going one-on-one. Again, he can do that as well. We just got to find that comfort zone and when to do it, knowing these guys can do it. Again, Austin looking for his shot down there, and he was really tremendous. Good rebound there by Jake. We're pushing the basketball. Great job by Ruben running the floor. And great pitch ahead. Getting some easy baskets. Again, we're running Austin screens. Again, he jumps up there and shoots it. I'm so happy to see him shoot that basketball.
Well, Coach, you said it begins and ends with defense, but boy, the offense really caught fire. And as we mentioned, Austin Anderson had an incredible second half because he really can shoot.
Well, he really can, Eric, and he was doing a couple of things mechanics-wise. He was kind of jumping a little sideways and not really getting his legs into the shot and getting a really good arch. And he's like Jordan when he has a great follow-through and holds his follow-through and uses his legs and gets arch on that basketball. I mean, it's going in. And to have two guys out there that can shoot the ball like they can will not only open up for Will Truss, but we need to drive that ball a little bit more and getting those guys shots.
All righty, Coach, let's go ahead and take our first time out. When we come back, the old rivalry is renewed, the Wofford Terriers. We're going to talk about that game, look at the highlights, also talk about the health of the Blue Hose basketball team with the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. All that and more ahead in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run! Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
Around here, we grew up in the kitchen. We learned how to cook when our parents taught us what their parents taught them. At Bojangles, our master biscuit makers use traditional Southern recipes too. From scratch, the old-fashioned way. It's harder, but it's better. Around here, kitchens have always brought folks together. And we're going to make sure they do so for a long time to come. Head to Bojangles and try our hickory-flavored smoked sausage on a made-from-scratch buttermilk biscuit. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by McDonald's of Lawrence and Clinton. I'm loving it. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, I know it was an exciting evening for you because your Blue Hose are going to tangle with the Terriers from the SoCon once again.
Well, it was, and most importantly, Eric, it was a team that really went to the NCAA tournament last year, three of the last 5 years. They got everybody back that went to the NCAA tournament, so I knew it was going to really be a big test for us in terms of we did have two really nice wins against non-D1 opponents and beat them pretty good, and but they were coming off a 4-point loss at William & Mary. I knew they were really going to be ready to go, and it was a great learning situation for our young guys of really being in a Big South, conference game or on the road in terms of they were really ready to play. They played just a little bit harder at times, especially on the blockout, which is all effort type of things. We got to block out better, take better care of the basketball. But really defensively overall, they shot 39%. Mm-hmm. They were .80 on the OER. We played enough defense other than the blockout. They killed us with 17 offensive rebounds. We've got to finish that. And unfortunately, we had 17 turnovers to their 7. So those two differentials gave them 16 more possessions.
So, Coach, even with good math, keeping the opponent to under 45% shooting or even in the 30s, if they get more possessions than you and if they get second chance opportunities off of the offensive boards, then they can get more points.
Well, and that's what's sad is we're putting too much pressure, whether it be on our offense or putting way too much pressure on our defense. They had 10 points off turnovers in the first half. It's an 8-point game. And then they also had 9 offensive rebounds. So it's a double-edged sword for us. It sticks out like a sore thumb in terms of a coach. What do we got to work on? Mm-hmm. We've got to block out better, whether we're in the man or zone, and give more effort. That's all it is blocking out. And then we've really got to do a good job of taking better care of the basketball and not turning it over.
One thing that we're going to see on the highlights, Coach, is the matchup between Cochran and Jordan Downing. As we mentioned, Jordan Downing has one of the purest, sweetest form of a jump shot you'll see in college basketball, and Cochran really couldn't handle him there.
Well, that was a big matchup, and I'm really so proud of Jordan. Mm-hmm. He went 4-for-16, Cochran did, and Jordan has really given the effort defensively and couldn't be proud of his effort, along with, Will's got to stay out of foul trouble, but we need those two guys, but they're really giving – you know, maximum effort, you know, defensively, and now we gotta help those two.
Well, see, I'm talking about Jordan offensively. Coach immediately goes to the defense. That's where it begins and ends with Coach Nibert. Let's go ahead, Coach, and dive in and take a look at those highlights. PC and Wofford.
Well, it was good to get back in there, and again, they coming up here offensively. One is setting some screens. We need to set better screens here for Jordan. They really did a good job of really showing on every screen. Good pass out there to Will. Great. That's inside and out at its best right there. And we showed some really patience in there. Jordan could have shot the ball twice. He shot faked and even got the ball down inside there to Ed twice. And Ed gets the dunk, which was a great finish by Ed. Again, we're running a little baseline runner. Again, we're not getting a good screen. Again, great pass out there. Again, going inside out. Great pass there by Ed. Again, they're on the miss. We're pushing the basketball. They did a good job here. If you notice, Will posting up in there. Will's got to get down there. He's posting up way too far outside. Mm-hmm. Again, we've got to run to the rim. Again, don't get anything out there. We've got to go back outside. Again, we're not screening. Again, good offensive move there by Austin and Will setting the screen. Again, Austin shot the ball well again. Again, we've got to screen better. We're standing straight up in the air. Again, Will catching it. Great pass out. I was real happy for Janelle Jenkins. He making two threes out there. And great pitch ahead there by Jordan. Again, good shot fake. And good another pull-up jump shot there by Austin. We're right in the game. We had to go to a little bit of the zone. Again, great job there. You know, they tried the lob play. Good job there by Ruben. Again, we need a quicker outlet. Again, screen and running a staggered screen. Again, they really showed on that screen. We need to swing the ball and go down there faster in the Will. You know, we do get it down there to Will, which is one of the best times we did it right there, and that was one of the easiest 2 points. We just don't do it enough.
When he's that deep,
when he's that deep, he can't be guarded. But he's got to work harder to get that deep. Again, great face up there by Ruben. And he can do more of that. Again, we're moving the ball. Need to make sure, again, we're setting better. That's pretty good there by Ed. Getting down there and getting wide, running a little set play here, shot clock play. Need to screen more down in the lane, but we get him the ball right there. He jumps straight up there and shoots that shot and doesn't even know Cochran's there. Again, we're swinging the basketball, again, trying to get the ball down inside there to Will. Again, they double team. Great pass out. Great penetrating pitch by Marcus there. We need, as you guys talked about, we need to do more of that. Again, pushing the ball. Good job there. Will finally gets almost down there to where we want him. We get the ball all the way in the lane, you know. Again, more penetration by Marcus, and he can do that. Giving those guys the freedom to do that. Again, another penetration, you know. And then Marcus shooting a nice pull-up jump shot. Again, here on defense, again, the job that Jordan does in there, jumping out there. And this is a great finish by Jordan with a 6'7 guy, but he's backpedaling, you know, and Jordan takes it strong.
Yeah, where was the and one?
Again, another drive there, right to the middle there by Marcus, which he can do that. We just got to get in those situations a little bit more. Again, another penetrating pitch, and then off the dribble.
Well, Coach, you talk about Will Truss getting deep in the lane. The other thing that we've noticed that he's developed is he's able to go with the opposite foot and the opposite hand as he's able to spin on the right block and finish with his right hand.
Well, he is, and they really did a pretty nice job, and we've got to work on this, and people holding him up and not letting him get down there that low, because when he gets that low, I mean, he's
it's
one of the best
over.
In the country.
Yeah, it's all over. Yeah.
Nobody's been able to stop him, so he's got to work harder. He does have that nice little jump hook there going to his left on the right block, and he spins back, and he's got a great right hand. When he gets it that deep, it's either a layup or a beautiful left-hand hook. So teams are trying to stop him. We got to get down there and get that ball in there to him more, and he's doing a good job of making some passes out. But that was a great inside game, like running the football. We got to get it down there to him.
Talk about your backcourt for a moment, because now you're getting more athletes coming in to be part of this basketball program. The backcourt seems to be getting better and better.
Well, we got to, you know, that's something we're going to, you know, keep taking a look at. And sometimes, You know, we're having a freshman out there, and Devon's doing a nice job with Janiel, but they're young, and sometimes we don't get some things run because of the inexperience and looking at some a little at Austin at the point
right.
there, too, and,
right.
and just with his shooting and knowing the system's going to be running the set plays and things like that. So we've got three really good guards out there. We might use all three of them in different scenarios
That's
and
right.
different situations depending on, you know, what we need. I'm really pleased with Janiel in terms of how he's coming along. He doesn't know the system yet. Devon's, again, coming along as well, but might need some leadership over there with Austin, you know, getting the set plays running and things like that.
And Janiel, 8 points in that contest. You saw those two big threes playing wonderful basketball and still getting better and better. And this, folks, is all, you know, you got to remember, this is a young basketball team that's out without Reggie Dillard, the sophomore, and without Murray, who's still a few weeks away from returning. So all this going on with two of our better players on the bench. Coach, let us go ahead and take a look at the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, and if you can tell us how that's working out now.
Well, it's great. Reggie is going to have his surgery the Friday, the finishing of finals, so we're mm-hmm. going to wait till after that so he can get his grades in academics. And Deshaun got his cast off. So that was great, and he can run and do some things there physically to stay in great shape, and then hopefully he'll be cleared to rehab on December 31st, and we'll be back hopefully by January 5th, and be ready for Winthrop at home on January 8th, and obviously Reggie will be out the whole entire year, but he'll obviously get a redshirt year and get him back, but we need his leadership and everything over there on that bench, and Deshaun hopefully he's watching and be ready to go as well.
All righty, Coach, let us go ahead and take this last time out. When we come back, the Bear Transport look ahead. PC has 3 straight games at home. We'll talk about those when we return.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
That's a wrap, Scotty. Let's break for lunch, guys.
All right, it's boat time.
Two-piece dinner.
Right here.
Hey, I had a two-piece dinner.
Relax, man. We got more. Cajun filet biscuit.
That's me.
You got a Cajun filet biscuit and a two-piece dinner?
So what's your point?
Man, you can't have breakfast and lunch together. That doesn't work.
Works for me. I call it brunch.
Get our famous chicken, made from scratch buttermilk biscuits, and legendary iced tea anytime you crave it. Bojangles, it's bow time.
You're watching Inside Blue Hose Basketball on the CW.
Okay, what was that?
I don't know.
It's over there.
Let's get out of here, dude. Run! Oh, hey.
How's it going?
McDonald's proudly serves McDonald's after midnight. A limited breakfast menu plus your late-night favorites.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you in part by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance. You're in good hands with Allstate and with Jeff Smith. 106 West Main Street, Clinton.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by Bojangles. It's bow time. The city of Clinton, where the tea is sweet and the tea is silent.
and by Hickory Hills Barbecue for all your barbecue catering needs.
We welcome you back. Now let's take a look at the Bear Transport look ahead.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
We welcome you back, Coach. Now you're going to take on another SoCon team, UNC Greensboro, a team that you defeated up in North Carolina with a complete effort.
Well, we did, and we really shot the lights out. We had a great everybody played well. Jordan, we obviously had Reggie back, Austin up there at top, and Will Truss. So, we really got to score some points again, and hopefully we can shoot the ball like we did there up there. And they've got a great offensive team, so it's going to be a big test for us in terms of playing great defense, and hopefully we can play a little zone and some man-to-man and do a tremendous job there with the team there. They've not won many games, but they've had a very difficult schedule. But they're scoring a lot of points. They're scoring in the 70s, so we're going to have to play great defense.
All righty, Coach. This will be the first of three games at home, all tune-ups, as you open up conference play at the end of the month.
Well, it is, and that's what that Wofford game was such a tune-up, and to go against an NCAA team, and you were right in that game with 14 minutes to go. We're down three, but we go on it. We've had these bad lulls where we turn the ball over and don't get a shot, and then that frustrates you, and we've just got to continue to do a better job of with our offense and then blocking out like we've talked about. And this team has a lot of potential, so we're very excited.
All righty, Coach. Thank you very much for joining us once again. And we want to see you in the Templeton Center because beginning today, three games at home. Let's cheer on the Blue Hose. For Gregg Nibert, I'm Eric Thacker. Till then, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. And Fats Cafe of Clinton. We'd like to thank the following Blue Hose sponsors. Swaim Brown Accounting Services and Wealth Management with David Ramage. Bishop Tire. Pepsi-Cola. Number One Sign Designs. Nichols Automotive. Foothills Motorsports. Arthur State Bank. Babcock Sports. Domino's Pizza. Streamers. Pizza Hut. Sodexo Food Services. The Camp Team. Hampton Inn. Thank you again for being Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors.